Hello and welcome to a brand new chapter of Global Techniques of Architecture. Into today's video, we are going to discuss about something called spider glazing. So spider glazing is a very common sort of glazing which is being visible into each and every aspect of our daily routine, whether it be visiting a mall, whether it be going to office, whether it be going to a showroom. So the central idea of this spider glazing is basically suspended glazing. Anything which is the glass, wherein the glass is being suspended from the top, we consider it as spider glazing. So what happens with this spider glazing is there are many types of this. So if at all you ask somebody from the industry to speak about spider glazing, they would fumble up. Even I fumble up many a times. So before presenting you this video, of course the basics have been revised. So I take this opportunity to thank each and every viewer of mine and the subscriber who has been consistently watching and encouraging me to make such new videos every alternate day. So thanks for that. And with that positive note, we dive into the details of clearing the concept of spider glazing. So we start with the least and we go with the maximum load transferring system, right from glass fin to the cable net. So the most preferable, the most easiest way to understand a glass fin system is a glass fin system itself, wherein instead of a mullion and a transom, glass fins laminated, if you go back to my previous video, laminated glass fins are to be used. So when I say laminated glass fins, those have to be heat soaked. So why heat soaked? You can go back to my previous videos and get to know more about this. So heat soaking, because those are more structural values, more detailed ones. And since this laminated fin would be playing the role of a structural member, we need to have this verified by a structural engineer. So if at all you ask me about the installation practice, the glass, the front glass as well as the glass fin remain in tension. Entire glass, entire facade or spider glazing remains in tension. And that's the sole reason for which it performs the best. Of course, we have glass to glass splice plates to join the two fins together. So specification wise, if at all there is a drill hole in glass, we have always recommended to go with a laminated as well as toughened glass. I hope you guys have seen those videos. If not, please have a look at those. Second system that comes into the mind is tension rod system. So tension rod, you have a rod in between and then you have tension ropes. So during the positive wind gust, if the wind is moving towards your facade, it will hit the elevation and the inner part of the rope, tension rod, would go under tension, whereas the outer one will remain in compression. Similarly, if at all there is a negative wind load, this outer one will be released and going into compression, whereas the inside one, the outside one will go again in compression. So this is a vice versa thing that keeps on happening, and the rod maintains the tension between these two wires. So it is also called tension wire system. We also call it tension rod system. It is beautifully installed at Mumbai International Airport. You can go and have a look at it. And the third system is truss based system, wherein you have a height of more than 12 meters, 14 meters, 16 meters, 20 meters. So we always go with the truss based system. So there is an entire truss, and that truss is a load bearing truss. It takes the entire load, and the glasses are held with the help of spiders with four holes. And every glass has four holes, and every spider holds the part of the glass and the junction of all these four glasses. next system comes is cable net system. So this cable net system is of more importance, because if at all you want to go with a cable net system, it has to be conceived at day one, planned at day one. So if at all a glass fin system, just for figures, understanding of figures, if at all a glass fin system requires M30, glass truss would be requiring M40, and if at all this is supposed to be of cable net, so cable net, of course, the system is the spigots, the compression fitting, or the compression fittings are held with the help of cable, and this cable is straightly into tension from the top and bottom, and it is tightened up. Because of this torsion, because of this torque of the tension to create that vertical facade, this exerts a load which would be even not accommodate, which the concrete of even say M60 won't be able to accommodate without proper reinforcement of a I section or a girdle. So we require much more planning to have a cable net system. If at all you want to have a look at cable net system, and if you are in Mumbai, go and have a look at Atria Mall. That's one of the best cable net system installed till date. And last but not the least, the takeaway from the video is, nowadays, after witnessing many projects wherein we could do forensic to one of those, many of the projects were failing because of nickel sulfide impurities. Now we have changed the specifications from FT to HS, and without holes in glass. So if you look at this picture, we are transferring the entire load of spigots or drill holes into glass from the holes to the compression fittings. So when I say there are compression fittings, there are no holes in glass, and if at all there are no holes in glass, we don't require FT glass, and if at all we have no FT glass, we don't have nickel sulfide impurity. Are you with me on this? So once I say there is no FT glass, there is no nickel sulfide, and hence this lamination can be of HS glass, which is now heat strengthened glass. I hope this has cleared many more misconceptions and doubts about facades as far as suspended, frameless or spider glazing goes. So if at all you have any doubts pertaining to this just concept clearing, please do comment me with the help of a comment, and we'll be happy to help you and answer the entire query. Once again, thanks for coming back to the channel and having watched this video till the end. Once again, thanks for watching.